Hello and welcome. This is Kristen, Science and Engineering Librarian at Miami University Libraries, and this video is on creating annotated photos or images. As we know, for most any data visualization, there are plenty of software options available, but as many people already have Microsoft PowerPoint on their computer and are likely somewhat familiar with it already, that's what we're going to use today. There's a ton of applications for this kind of visualization, so let's see a couple of examples, and then we'll make one together. This first example I made for some library instruction, I took several screenshots like the one on the left from different databases and then assembled them into the image on the right, showcasing a similar feature in them all, the permalink or sharing link or feature. Now I can easily show at a glance using those red boxes where it is and what it looks like in these different databases. Okay, another example from library land. This is another annotated screenshot, but I didn't put multiple screenshots together here. This is Miami's Oxford campus, and no, we aren't in Florida, we are in Ohio. This map highlights where the three library locations are on campus and has their names, much larger and clearer than the text on the map. We could be here a long, long time looking at other examples, but just after seeing these two, you can probably start thinking of some similar images you've seen elsewhere or the one that you have in mind that you'd like to make. So let's start on our example. Okay, so here we are in PowerPoint. We've got a totally blank slide right now, and we need to insert our picture that we're going to annotate. So to do that, we want to go up to Insert, and then to Pictures. If you click this little arrow here, then you can insert a picture from your device, which is what I'm going to do, or you can get pictures from online. So let's do that real quick. Okay, so we've got our picture now, and I've also got some notes in these little blue callouts here. Those are just for the sake of the video. Let's talk about this picture. I'd be kind of surprised if anybody watching this could tell me right away what this is, which is kind of why we're using it as an example. It should become more clear with annotations and perhaps other images, and that's really the goal of not just this, but any data visualization, is to communicate. What do you want to communicate? To whom are you communicating? And how do you want to do that? So what I suggest to do first is just take a moment, think about what you want to add to this. Do we want to add an outline or some arrows or some text? Do we want to add another picture or a before and after shot to compare them? What do we want to do? Okay, so after giving it some thought, let's add some shapes and some text to this to help explain what this is. Right up here at the top, we're still in the Insert menu, and if we come over here under Illustrations and to Shapes, and we click on this, it gives us a ton of choices. Let's look and see what we have here. We've got lines and arrows, some rectangles, some other kinds of blocky arrows, some flowchart shapes and stars. For this, I am going to use a bracket. Okay, so for me, somebody who knows what we're looking at already, I'm going to call out this section here as one thing. We'll do another. We need to go back to Insert, back to Shapes, do another bracket, highlight out this part, and we will do one more, and we'll put that last one right here. Okay, so we've got something going on now. We're calling attention to the three different parts, and now let's add some text. We'll go back to Insert, and then we have Text Box as a choice right over here under Text. Let's click where we want it. Let's add another one. You can go back to the Insert menu every time. Sometimes what I like to do is click on the one that I've done already, and you can do Control D to duplicate it, and that'll just give you the same thing again, and then you can just edit it. Sometimes I feel it's a little faster. Let's do that once more. Okay, so just quickly, because you can get really carried away with the formatting, if you wanted to change the text for these, you can simply click on them. If you want to press Shift and highlight them all so they all change at once, you can do that. And then under the Home menu, you can adjust the font to something else that you'd like. And similarly, you can do this with the shapes. Let's highlight them all together here. So as the default, they were just a very thin blue line. If we go up to Shape Format, and this tab only appears when you have any shapes highlighted, then you can change the fill color, the outline, you can adjust the weight, which just makes the lines appear a little bit bolder. So you can stylize these to your heart's content. We're not going to go into that too much, but just so that you know, you can do that. And that's actually what I've done a little bit on this next slide, basically the same as what I was working on, but we've got brackets on either side, and I did change the font. Okay, let's look at another shape or another way that we might annotate this just to show a little variety. Go back to Insert, Shapes, and this time let's use an arrow. Now when you choose the arrow, you can send it in whatever direction you want to at any angle. If you want to have some control over which angle it is, like you want it to be totally straight, either horizontal or vertical, then you can press the Shift and then it will lock it in at some of those nice neat angles that we like. That helps it look nicer. Okay, again, let's use that Control D feature on the keyboard to duplicate it, and we will put another one down here. All right, let's add in one more arrow going down. We can also add text to these as we did in the previous example. Let's see what that looks like. Okay, so lastly, let's pull it together with a picture to help communicate what this is and what the different parts are. We will go up to insert picture, grab one from this device, and then we will combine it with the annotations that we had before. So we have the preview up here at the top with these little brackets. We've got the pattern itself, again with brackets, the URL if you wanted to access this online, and a picture of what this is. So we could tell from the annotations before that this was a pattern. Turns out it's a pattern for making a friendship bracelet, and this is what that pattern looks like when it is finished. So altogether, this image makes a lot more sense now to people who don't make friendship bracelets. If you do make friendship bracelets, you knew right away what this was. If you don't, this helps communicate the bigger picture. So when it is all finished like this, and you're done, you can leave it here in PowerPoint if that's where you're gonna use it in some sort of presentation, or you can save it as a JPEG or a PDF if you wanna use it somewhere else. I have another video on this YouTube channel about how to do that. You can also just do a print screen or a screen capture and save it that way. All right, let's wrap up this video on creating annotated images in Microsoft PowerPoint. I hope this was helpful for you and your project. Different versions of PowerPoint we might use might mean that some of the features I showed are in different menus or places, and you might see other features that weren't on my screen, but fingers crossed that it's by and large the same. Please reach out to the library if you have any questions, and thanks again for watching.